Hey gardening friends, today we're going to do a plant spotlight on white snakeroot. Ageratina altissima is the Latin name. This is a native plant, native to the northeast. It's late blooming. I mean, today's November 2nd. It's been blooming since like the end of September. It's very popular with later pollinators because it's in the aster family. But one thing about this plant is it's highly toxic if eaten. You don't want to ingest it. You don't want animals to eat it. Any mammals that eat it can die from it. And actually, milk from cows that have eaten it were known to kill early settlers. And possibly Abraham Lincoln's mother died from what they called milk sickness. But deer won't eat it. This is a good woodland plant. It actually tolerates a lot of shade. It gets 3 to 5 feet tall. It can be a bit aggressive though, as it will self-sow. And you can see here in the garden, it's kind of taken over this one area. It also spreads by rhizomes. It has rather large leaves. So when it's not blooming, it can look rather weedy. It would be better for a more natural site. Today, though, it's a nice sunny day. There's a lot of small pollinators out here checking it out. Nobody that wants to land and show themselves. Soil-wise, it likes medium to wet soils, but it does tolerate dry soils. This garden is actually pretty dry. It can be used in rain gardens also because it can take that wet to dry conditions. As I said, full sun to part shade, it does tolerate quite a bit of shade. Lots of times you'll see it growing right along the edges of a woodland or a shady area. We've got a little, can I get this little pollinator in here? No flies are landing on it. So, interesting plant. It will bloom till we have a hard freeze or frost. We've had a couple of frosts. It's been blooming since, I would say, the end of September. But if you're looking for something late blooming, as long as you're aware of its toxicity issues, this would be a good thing to add to the native garden. Have a great day.